I think we also need to understand the context of that letter. That letter was supposed to pass through Mr. Raphael Tuju. He is the Secretary General of the party. He is the custodian of all records of the party. It was then also copied to my majority leader, who is technically my colleague in the Senate. And therefore, for me, I think I did write that letter in good faith. Let me comment something. This is not the first time I'm raising matters concerning problems of BBI in our region. It's not the first time. If you follow news keenly, you recall there was a time members of parliament congregated at my business establishment, which is located in Karen Dagureti area. And several members of parliament had attended. These are the issues we discussed. Then it was decided, we escalate that issue. The following day in Karen, we met one of the principals behind BBI. Again, I raised this issue. In fact, the majority leader of the National Assembly, Mr. Kemunya, rose and said, there's no problem at all with BBI in our region. Only for members of parliament from that region to rise in that meeting and say, no, indeed, there is a problem. President Uhuru Kenyatta is my personal friend. I have campaigned for President Uhuru Kenyatta twice, 2013, 2017. In fact, I'm the only politician in this republic whose political motto had the name Kenyatta in it. I used to say it's Kenyatta and Kang'ata. In Kikuyu, ni Kenyatta na Kang'ata. So I have been a strong supporter of President Uhuru Kenyatta. So if for any reason that was to occur, there's nothing I can do. I just thank the party. For that period, I have served them as their leader. And I will remain respectful to my superiors and the authorities. I cannot enter into an arena of fighting with my boss, but I only strongly believe it is important as political leaders to say the truth, to report the truth, and to be honest and candid in our endeavor when it comes to matters like this one, which has potentiality to embarrass the government. By the way, I did not imply necessarily BBI will fail. You know, BBI can... No, I didn't say that. No, I think you ought to read that letter. You know, BBI can fail in Mount Kenya and it get endorsed in other regions. True or false? Of course. My observations were restricted to Mount Kenya region only. So it is possible for BBI to get endorsement in other regions, but it fails in Mount Kenya. That would have serious political repercussions on the government. Serious political repercussions, because it will mean there's a problem of government legitimacy in our region, where I come from, where my president, whom I love so much, comes from. To me, that's my main concern. It's not really the issue of BBI passing or not. It is how, what political message would be sent if it turns out BBI gets problem in our region.